The prophets of old had prophesied that the Messiah would be born in Bethlehem, a small town a few miles south of Jerusalem. But Bethlehem was not Joseph or Mary's hometown. They had to make the journey to Bethlehem because Caesar Augustus had made a law that everyone must be counted in the towns where their great-great-grandparents had been born. This is a long trip to travel by foot, about 60 miles or 3 days. It would have been even more difficult since Mary was pregnant and riding on the back of a donkey. Now is the night, time, and in the fields outside of him, shepherds were watching their flocks. An angel appeared before the shepherds, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them. The shepherds were terrified, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I've got good news for you that will amaze you and bring you great joy, and not just for you, but for all people. To you is born tonight in the city of David a Savior who is the Messiah. This will be the sign you have found him. You will find a baby wrapped in bandage cloth and lying in a manger." Immediately after the angels stopped speaking, there were suddenly many angels praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." Then the angels left the shepherds, and the shepherds took a deep breath, or maybe 5 or 6 deep breaths. Then they looked at each other and said, "We better go see this baby." Now when the shepherds saw Mary, Joseph, and Jesus in this table, and that what the angel had said to them was true, they went out and made it known to whomever they met, which means it's very possible that some of the townspeople went to the stable that very night to see and maybe even help Mary, Joseph, and the baby Jesus because of what the shepherds had told them.
Thank you.
Tonight we celebrate and remember the birth of Jesus, not just because he was born, but because of the life that Jesus lived. The baby Jesus grew into an adult Jesus who chose to choose to live God's way all the time. It is exciting that Jesus was born of a manger, but what is even more exciting is that Jesus was born of a mother just like us and grew up just like us. Then when he was an adult, he chose to live God's way and said to us, "You can do this too, and here, I'll show you just how to. Just follow me." This is the good news today, and why we celebrate Christmas, because Christmas is a story that reminds us that all of us can choose to live God's way as God's sons and daughters. So let's go from here today giving thanks to God for Jesus and remind others that the gift of Jesus is that he chose to live God's way and live to show us how we can do the exact same thing.
Can we have our dancers to come out, please? They have another engagement. Come on out, guys. They're getting changed. Well, then I'm going to explain what's going to happen next. Because you know the best laid plans, what happens to the best laid plans? Something happens, and the best laid plans don't end up happening. The person who is going to lead us in the solo of Happy Birthday Jesus, he's sick, and I didn't get it arranged to do anything different. So we're going to do something with a lovely tune, which you'll have to wait until next year, and we'll do it next year instead. When the kids are done, what we're going to do is we're going to sing Happy Birthday to Jesus, is what we're going to do. All the kids watching, come on up, and we're going to get a picture taken. Here, and I just want to stop and say thank you to our dancers. I want to especially say thank you to Mariana for all the work that you did in pulling that together. So thank you so much. Come on over here, guys. So we're going to just sing the traditional version. Everybody know Happy Birthday? Do you know it off by heart, Stuart? On the piano? Oh, we're just going to use the regular. We're going to use the usual one. Just the usual Happy Birthday. Because that one.
Become real in our lives as we continue to tell your story. Amen.
Amen. So one of the things that we do when we come together as the church to worship is we offer our prayers to God. And so now Gail is going to lead us in the prayers.